I just wanna get paid, I wanna be famous. Car with the tints, yard in the sticks, I don't wanna see neighbours. Get paid for rapping the bars, jacking the guard, just wanna be nameless. Not yakking the pack in the car, we took a few hours when it happened, we lost.
This is your boy TSB, and this is the breakdown of DC neighbourhoods. I love this song, man. Love this song. Shout out my bro DC as well, because he done his thing. This is the first song we ever made together, actually. And it ended up being the first single off his project, which is out now, In The Loop. So make sure you check that out. Go get that. In The Loop was sick. I think I had like 5 songs on there as well. So I really enjoyed like being part of the process, creating with DC, and just like making a body of work that I feel like he's proud of, I'm proud of. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, man, proper sick. So I'm just gonna get into it. Neighborhood. This one of my favorite beats. I feel like I say that a lot, but I guess I love what I'm making it. Definitely one of my favorite beats. So I'm just gonna start with the intro, which is the piano. Actually see that I've played it in, I've just bounced that out in place. Just makes it easier sometimes when I'm working, workflow, etc, etc. Had this little cool melody line which came in here, which I played in again. So what we got next is the famous vocals. Played around on arcade, found like a nice library with nice vocals which I liked, and that's how I came up with that. I love the vocal on this track in terms of even just in the production. After that, I added like a bass line which you kind of hear throughout the song. So quite simple, and that just adds to the bounce. Then there's like a little tape stop as well to signify we're coming into the next section of the song. Now I'm going to play you the verse, but just the instruments again before I get into what I did in terms of the drums and the drum programming. So pretty similar to the intro, vocal, sample, bass line and the piano, those things all remain the same. I then added like this guitar lick that I was playing around with, different little melodies again from arcade, and this is what it gave me. So I'm just going to solo it quickly so you can actually hear it just with the piano. So this is the guitar and the piano.
I just want to get paid, I want to be famous. Car with the tints, yard in the sticks, I want to see neighbours. Get paid for rapping the bars.
I'll play it as well without the vocal just so you can really hear it. A nice vibe. Cool. So we got the vocal and we've got the bass line as well, and that is pretty much the verse melody. The only thing that I then added was an 808 which comes in the second half, and I added some strings. You'll hear the strings now. Basically just to support the piano, so there's some strings in there too. 808 comes in there as well.
I say how I feel, but it's hard to explain. That's why.
Cool. So that was just to kind of keep the song moving, keep the tempo, build up a bit. It's time for more. The verses are 32 bars, so it's like the second 16. I wanted to just start adding things and making things feel a bit more prominent. And then in the hook, instrument wise as well, I think I only added that one or two instruments. I used this piano plugin called Addictive Keys, and I played this melody, but it kind of felt like a weird kind of synth which comes in the hook. So I'll play you that so you can actually get an idea of what that sounds like. That sounds like this.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It just reminded me of like old school grime, that kind of vibe. Just something different. Sounded mad underground, so that's why I felt like I should use it. So if I start to put that back in with one or two things, you get this. Cool. Now, one of my signatures, you can see it's called 808 Melody. I love to play 808s like their chords. So instead of playing them low on the keyboard where it's like low for the bass, I'm playing them a lot higher up on the keyboard, like higher register. And it just gives you a different vibe. So when you shorten the 808 or do the relevant things to it, you can actually get really nice sound out of it, which is what I did here. So that with the vocal. So yeah, that was the hook melody. I'm gonna play it to you one more time just so you can understand what was going on in the hook. And I think the only other thing I did is in the hook, I took out the piano. So the piano that was prominent in the intro. And in the,
we just wanna get paid, we don't wanna know drama.
I kept the strings in there as well. So with the vocal, we ain't in no drama.
We just wanna get paid, we don't wanna know drama. Stepping in filthy, the light how coming disgusting. I'm out here till it kills me. Don't look, mommy, I'm hustling. I don't keep.
So I'm just gonna give you the drums now, and then I'll show you a little bit of the second verse. Cause in the second verse, I added some like intricate little things. But yeah, drums. Let's go for the drums. So again, I tend to like have all my stuff in the drum bus. Makes my life easy. Nice little kick roll in there. Love my kick rolls. You can see that here. Cool. So, snares, hi-hats. Loads of different hi-hats. Like, if I unsolder the drum bus and do it this way. Another hat. One rim. Now I want to show you some of the actual drums as well. So that's really what was going on in terms of the hats. And then I had this proper sick like percussion loop, and I just found a different way to use it. Just chopping it in the right places. It reminded me of like this kind of Brazilian kind of feeling loop. I'm actually just gonna play you what that loop would have sounded like if I didn't chop it. Yeah, so just chopping up, giving it flavor. I'm gonna add the kick drum back in now. Let's see what you have. And then you're in. Without the piano. You're just in. But with the piano. Have like a couple rises. I've got a couple cymbals and just crashes and things where it makes sense. I'm just going to briefly show you the second verse as well. So in the second verse, to start the second verse, I brought in this piano here. I think at the time I called it piano zoinks, Because it was just a madness that I played, like, in terms of the melody. I played it proper quick. It was mad skippy. I ran it through, like, Retro Color, RC20, a couple other plugins to get the feel. So that's the start of the verse, the second verse.
Smile on my face, but it's better that they judge me. Made some mistakes that were ugly, but you can't think straight when...
Cool, that's the first half of the second verse. And you can actually see, again, I've just bounced it out, but this is the MIDI for what I played, which you can see here. So yeah, man, I was just having a lot of fun with it, a lot of fun with it. Now, after that section comes the second half of the second verse, where I bring the keys back in, the main piano. The strings come back in here too. I also do one or two interesting things here. So I brought in like this little, I call it like a sax sound, but it wasn't really that much sax, but you hear it here. I'll just bring the volume up so you can actually hear what was going on if I said. Something along those lines, but yeah, I was just having fun with it. Sax line. I think I had an electric piano as well, which I played, which comes in here. Yeah. Just to support the main piano. So just like nice little things. Right. So you can tell I was really like, I was probably in my feelings or something when I made it, because there's a lot going on, but. Saxophone EP together sounds like this. Smooth. I put the drums back in, you get this.
Filthy.
That's pretty much DC Neighborhood. Outro as well, I done some little cool things, just kind of bringing in some of the same elements that I brought in before. Nothing crazy with this one. I've pretty much shown you all the individual sounds, why I use them, how I use them. You've got 808s there playing bass, playing chords. You've got piano, you've got electric piano, you've got affected piano, you've got like synthy piano, you've got arcade doing like guitar chops, vocal chops, and then I've got serum where I'm like playing a lead as a bass, and then you've seen the drums as well. So that's pretty much how we created DC Neighborhood. Shout out DC again. In the Loop is out now, so make sure you have a listen to that amazing body of work that I'm proud to be a part of. So yeah, this has been TSB. And this is DC Neighborhood Breakdown.
The night how coming disgusting. I'm out here till it kills me. Don't look, mommy, I'm hustling. I don't care if they feel me. The talk ain't doing me nothing.